Hello everyone, my name is Ankit Verma and today we will discuss WP model and its working. WP enables the access of internet in mobile devices.
Let us suppose we are having a mobile and a server. The mobile is acting like a client and the server is acting like web server which provide the internet connectivity to the mobile. If we are using the PC, which is personal computer, instead of mobile in this diagram, then we don't need WAP. But as we are using mobile phone, so we need WAP gateway. WAP provide the internet connectivity from web server to the mobile phone. The client is having different components like WML, WML script, and WTAI. WAP gateway contain the components like encoder decoder, WML script compiler, and protocol adapter. Web server contain the components like CGI script and WML DEX. First, we are learning the client. In the client, the first component is WML. WML stands for Wireless Markup Language, which is based on XML. XML is Extensible Markup Language. WML is a markup language for devices that use WAP, such as mobile phone. So, your mobile phone, which we are using, use WAP. So, WAP provides the internet to the mobile phone. WML is like HTML, which provide navigational support, data input, hyperlink, text and image presentation, and form. So we can say that WML is similar to the HTML, where we can create the form, we can import the text, image, and the hyperlink, similar to the HTML. But HTML is a page, while WML is a card. WML take care of the small screen and low bandwidth of transmission. That is most important for the mobile, because the mobile having the small screen and it also work on the low bandwidth of transmission. That's why WML is good for the mobile phone. Next component is WML script. WML script is client-side scripting language which use WML. Next component is WTAI. WTAI stands for Wireless Telephony Application Interface. WTAI is protocol which is used with WAP that allow a telephone number to be linked with a web page. So if you want to link the mobile phone or the telephone number with the web page, then we need WTAI. Next one is WAP gateway. The first component is encoder and decoder, which is used to encode and decode the messages. Next one is WML script compiler, which is going to compile the WML script. And next one is the protocol adapters. Next is web server. The web server, the first component is CGI script. CGI stands for Common Gateway Interface. CGI script is any program that run on the web server. CGI define a way in which information may be passed between browser and the server. Any communication which is happening between browser and the server is taken care by CGI. Next one is WML DEC. WML file can contain multiple cards and they form a DEC. So a DEC can contain multiple cards. When WAP enabled device like mobile phone goes to a WAP site, the mobile browser loads a WML file that contain a deck of card from the server.
Now we will discuss the working of WAP model.
Step 1. Open the micro browser on WAP enabled device and type the URL of website. So first of all, you are going to open your mobile phone. You will open the browser of your mobile. The mobile browser which we are using is called micro browser. So micro browser is a term which we say to the browser in mobile communication. So now you are opening the micro browser and you are just typing some URL. So example, the google.com. Step 2. URL is sent using WAP protocol to WAP gateway. In second step, a WAP request is sent from client to WAP gateway, which contain the same URL which you have opened. Step 3. WAP gateway translate this WAP request into HTTP request for that specified URL and send it to the web server. So in step 3, WAP gateway just pass on the same URL to web server and it convert it to HTTP request. Now the web server takes some static file or CGI output WML if required. Step 4. Web server process the URL request, add HTTP header to WML content and return it to WAP gateway. So in step 4, the web server process the URL which you have asked, then the result, which is the WML content, is wrapped with HTTP header, and this HTTP response, which is having WML content, is passed on to WAP gateway. Step 5. WAP gateway send WML content to the WAP device using WAP protocol. Micro browser process WML content and display on device screen. So in step 5, WAP gateway give a WAP response which contain a WML content to the client. The client is the mobile phone. Now the mobile phone is having the WML content. The micro browser of your mobile phone open that WML content and display on the device screen. Means on your mobile phone, you will be having the site which you have requested. So the URL you have typed is now on your mobile phone screen.
So that's all about WAP model. Thank you.